I just like being in the water and I like corals and fish, so every day that we get to do this is a good day in my book.
Biscayne National Park is a truly special place. It is the largest marine park within the national park system. It preserves mangrove coastlines, it has Biscayne Bay, tropical hardwood hammock islands, and then of course the northern extent of the Florida Reef Tract. Biscayne's reefs have been known to be in decline for some time now. We have lots of problems going on with water quality, overfishing, a lot of use that's resulting in degradation of the habitat and pollution. And in the last few years, we've had outbreaks of both coral bleaching followed by coral disease. And the disease has now reached epidemic levels, and not a whole lot is actually known about what's caused it and how we can control it, if we can control it.
For my project, I hope to figure out if there's a connection between the health of the coral and the different types of fish and groups of fish that you see associated with the coral reef habitat there. Just by going in the field, taking data, and then analyzing it later and seeing if they one correlates with the other.
That's why we're excited to have Juliet here with her project, because we are continuing to collect fish data as we have throughout the years, and now she can add this component looking at the coral reefs that the fish are utilizing.
Well, today everybody else is doing RVCs, which are fish surveys that they do every other year, and I'm tagging along with them and doing coral surveys alongside it. So I'm going to be documenting what type of coral is there, how healthy is it, how much of it is bleached, if it's diseased, and what kind of disease, and how much of it is diseased, in order to try to figure out if the fish assemblages are influenced by the health of the coral in the area.
The temperature is what first comes to mind when people think about impacting coral health, and usually when the temperatures increase, they're more susceptible to bleaching, and when they're more susceptible to bleaching, they're more likely to become infected with diseases.
I saw some coral, and I think I saw a little bit of disease down there, which is exciting and also kind of sad. There's a little bit of bleaching also, and so it'll be interesting to see, you know, why this site, because I hadn't really seen that much of the other ones yet.
So we anticipate that we will continue to lose corals, and we need to know how that is going to affect the fish, because the fish are a major ecologically important and economically important part of Biscayne and the greater region.
I saw my first manatee last week.
Really?
Yeah, it was so exciting.
My experience here as an FPL intern has been great. It's really awesome because I get to work not only on my own project that's associated with climate change, but also get to help out with the other scientists and biologists that work here at the park with normal park day-to-day projects and activities. So I really feel like I'm getting a full experience of what it would be like to work in the national parks.
Juliet has been really great to work with. She came on very knowledgeable, highly experienced in the realm of marine science. She's an experienced diver. So she came right in, and it's been as if she's been here for much longer than she really has. She really did a great job of developing methods that complement our ongoing work.
I highly recommend doing this internship because you get to really go into the park service and see how things are done from the inside.
I really think it's a win-win situation. I can help them grow as scientists and learn the process of how to work in a national park, but they also can open my eyes to new possibilities. And many times some of the newer research we're doing is because interns have said, hey, what about this or what about that? And it might have been something that I didn't see or I didn't think about.